Hi everybody, I'm Emmanuel Nibise, and well, my topic is queer cinema. And I'm going to be talking about two movies, Girl by Lucas Daunt and Below Her Mouth by April Mullen. She's a Canadian actress and filmmaker. Well, the reason why I picked these two movies is because I wanted a movie where the transgender character and, you know, the gay or lesbian characters were the main characters in the movie, and I just couldn't find that. So I just thought, why not? I just picked two movies where this two type of people are the main character, and, you know, talk about it. Before we get into it, I just want to say this, viewer's discretion, because it's going to be nudity, and if you find that uncomfortable, I'm just going to give you a heads up before we get into, you know, discussing the movies. Before I start, I'm just going to start, give, like, say some few things about, you know, queer cinema. Well, queer, as we know, it's a word, and it means different. That's, yeah, different. So that's where queer cinema comes in. If normally we know the normal, you know, state of in the community is a woman marries a man or a man marries a woman, and if you're born a woman, you stay a woman, and if you're born a man, you stay a man. But now people are different. Now women can be in love with women and men can be in love with men. And if you're born a woman and you don't like it, you can change to being a man. And if you're born a man and you don't like it, you can be a woman. So, you know, those people are considered different. That's where queer comes in. Queer cinema is, I feel it's amazing. It's not fairy tale. Normally we see, oh no, the woman's in love with the man, but now we're seeing women in love with women. It's showing us true expression. Well, with all that said, I'm just gonna get into the history of, you know, queer cinema.
I'm gonna give you a brief history of, you know, the LGBTQ community. Hate crime was something that was really practiced, and it was practiced by, you know, people who are homophobic or, you know, transphobic. It was crazy. So a hate crime is defined as the victimization of individuals because of their actual or perceived race, ethnicity, or national origin, sexual orientation, religion, gender identity, or disability. It was so bad that this homophobic people were killing, you know, the LGBTQ community. On June 12, 2016, the popular gay dance club Pulse in Orlando was the site of a mass shooting by one assailant with at least 49 dead and another 50 injured. This hate crime is being called the worst mass shooting in U.S. history. Since the 1969 Stonewall riots against one of the many police raids on gay bars, there have been many more reports and instances of violence against LGBT people in the United States, and this is going on everywhere. All this doesn't just occur in the USA. It also happens in Canada. The LGBT community is not accepted. They were being killed. Trans men were being killed. It was not good. The reason I spoke about the killing and the homophobic nature of people towards queer people is because people, films now we watch show us how the struggles of coming out as gay or bisexual or as transgender. It shows us the struggle and the fear because people are afraid of coming out as, you know, bisexual or, you know, queer because they're afraid they wouldn't be accepted by society. So film, queer cinema, you know, show us films that, you know, encourage people to come out as queer. First movie I'm going to talk about is Girl. It's about a trans woman trying to fit in into the community. And the second one I'm going to talk about is Below Her Mouth. It's about two lesbians trying to, you know, figure out their lives, push away everyone away from them and just figure things out. I'm going to start with Girl by Lucas Daunt, a Belgian producer. Girl is a film about a transgender girl. She is trying her best to keep up with being a ballerina because it isn't working for her. She has bleeding toes, and she's also trying her best to keep up with, you know, the process of changing from male to female. It's a hard process. This movie shows us how they feel pain, how they're, you know, kind of made fun of. And I'm just going to show you a clip real quick.
Ja, de volgende alsjeblieft.
Een chance.
Drie, vier, vijf, zes, zeven.
Je klassieke techniek moet natuurlijk verder geperfectioneerd worden, maar voldoet. Dus ik denk dat het goed is dat we een achttal weken proberen.
C'est une nouvelle vie. C'est un grand moment pour la famille, pour nous trois.
De meisjes, we hebben hier al een 12 jaar op ons plans. Je zult moeten harder werken, anders is het een hopeloze situatie.
Je ziet er goed uit, gestraald. Heb je nog zitten aftellen naar je hormonenbehandeling?
Ja. We gaan de vrouwelijke puberteit zo goed mogelijk nabootsen. Maar de effecten zijn dus wel onomkeerbaar.
Het is wel compliqué. Tu veux me prendre pour une fille ou pour un mec?
Fille.
Et voilà.
Je te demande comment ça va parce que tu ne dis jamais rien. Voilà pourquoi je te demande comment ça va.
Il y a une raison, non?
Il y a une raison de quoi? Pourquoi tu ne dis plus jamais rien?
Ah, c'est peut-être parce que ça va pas.
On va pas venir au pied, hein?
Ah, non.
Alors, comment, Vlad? Stop! T'es dans une des meilleures écoles de danse du pays. T'as des médecins qui te suivent. Tout se passe bien. Hein? Tout se passe bien.
As we saw in the clip I just played, a lot of things happen when you're trans, when you decide to be transgender. A lot of things happen. You go through hormone therapy, which, you know, messes with your hormones. People make fun of you, like the girl. They made fun of her. And that's one thing queer cinema and films never fail to, you know, depict. They always show that it's not easy being transgender or, you know, queer. It's not easy. They go through a lot, and I really admire transgender people for that. But with that being said about girl, I'm gonna talk about Below Her Mouth. And this movie is directed by April Mullen. She is a Canadian actress and filmmaker. And this movie was an official selection at the Toronto International Film Festival. This movie is about two women who, you know, fall in love. Dallas and Jasmine. Jasmine is engaged. She's about to be married, and, you know, she falls in love with Dallas. Jasmine was, you know, in love with women right from when she was little. But her mother stopped her and told her she had to, you know, date and marry men. But she wasn't really into men. So when Dallas came her way, she fell in love, and, you know, sparks and fireworks. This shows us what the society is meant to look like, but us diverting from the society. Jasmine's mother told her that she had to, you know, marry a man, but once she was old enough, she made up her mind, I'm gonna be with a woman and not a man. And that shows us how tough the decision it is to make, to, you know, leave a path and move to another. Because Jasmine left her fiance, and, you know, she and Dallas were dating. So it shows us how hard it is to leave our, like, past lives and move on to what makes us happy. And I was kind of interested and happy that when I heard that the cast was an all-female cast. It was good. It was really nice. And it shows how independent women are. And also, this movie explains, it shows us the intimacy of, you know, female sex. Most people think, scissorsing, yeah. Women, all lesbians, always scissors. That's the main thing. That's it. But this movie shows us that it's more than that by not showing us scissorsing in one scene in the movie. It just shows us how intimate they were. They could be intimate how they like it. You must not necessarily scissors. So it shows us the intimacy of women and how they do it. So it's not necessarily ill in a way that maybe someone who hasn't had sex or a man described the way women have sex, but it's a whole different way. And she used below her mouth to show this to us. Well, with all that said, I can definitely tell you that queer film enlightens us. It tells us about the struggles of queer people and how they overcome it. And I feel like it's queer films tell us that, this person is queer and they're facing these problems. You're supposed to help and not add to the problems. I think that's what they tell us. And they show us how people are afraid to, you know, accept queer people in the society. Like the movies Lily's, the Simone's father flogged him for being gay. And that's what, like, most people are afraid to come out for being queer, because they're afraid they wouldn't be accepted in the society. And I think that's why queer films come in, tell us that if someone's queer in your society, accept them. It's who they are, and you can't change that fact. So yeah, and I just love queer films. Yeah, well, that will conclude all of everything I said. That will conclude it. Thank you for watching it, and bye.